Hey, horse people. I thought I did a video on this a while back. Maybe I just included in one. If I did do it, I can't remember it. So maybe some of y'all will remember me mentioning it or what I called it. But it's pretty cute with a little baby. I told a story where I tried to sneak up on a Tanner's herd one time, and there was a little baby that saw me, and the baby let out a little call, and Mr. T comes running from the back of this herd in an attacking mode, and he was just pinning ears, head down, snaking, running right at me. I thought he was going to kill me. I jumped out of the bush and yelled, "Tanner, Tanner, it's me." So this is the little, like, I'm nervous Winnie that that little colt let out that had Mr. T running, that he was worried. And in this video, a little colt hollers out for mom to come. And so let's take a look at mom comes, and then I'll kind of talk about some good and bad.
Still all legs too.
That's the answer.
Oh, here comes mom.
Here she comes. Watch out, babe. Watch out. Just stand back. He's fine. He's fine. He's fine. He's like, "Mom, they were touching me."
Very cute. Okay, so let's take a look at some good and bad here, and give the barn witches with no life something to come cry and complain about, and the rest of you who have a life that come here to learn, maybe you'll get something out of this. So, obviously, we have the little baby here, and these people, two women and a baby, two women and a child, whatever, they are petting or saying hello to the baby. The baby's running loose. Not a bad thing. I think that's probably a good thing. The fact that the mom left the baby at that distance says mom's probably pretty comfortable with the environment. And the fact when mom came up that she kind of ignored everybody says she was probably pretty confident and her baby was okay. So let's listen to the baby call.
Still all legs too.
Okay, so that little call right there, pretty much, I'm not sure if that's the same call that, because that's not a fear call. That's just kind of like I'm looking for mom. There's really no pressure on here to say that this horse was scared and worried. The horse isn't giving any nonverbal signs that it's really stressed. It's just kind of like, "Where's mom? I got these people around me and I don't see my mom," which is good. It should be closer to mom and it should want mom by it. And, you know, some idiot will be like, "Oh, that horse is, they need to separate them. That baby's getting mom sour," and all this other ignorance out there in the horse world. And you know what? It's good that she likes and feels comfort with her mom. It's good that she can call for her mom, her mom comes, and then she feels confident and she grows. So that was good. So I think that was an answer. That almost sounded like it came from the barn. But the way the baby's head, you kind of see the baby give that look to where mama's coming. It's very light and it's very quick. But she looks like, I think that's where mom's coming. See that little look in that little ear? Okay, I think mom's coming.
Oh, here comes mom.
Here she comes. Watch out, babe. Watch out.
Okay, so now the baby calls again. As soon as it makes sure it recognizes mom, it sees mom coming, it acknowledges her, it looks at her, it faces her. They're talking. The stupid humans did good here. The guy said, "Look out," and the women moved like they should have. And why are you trying to tell me what to do? Why are you being sad? Why can't I stand where I want to stand? Why do I need a man telling me to? You know, instead of getting in this argument, those women just went, they took a clue. They went, "Here comes mom. Maybe you ought to move." That's probably a pretty good tip. Maybe this guy wasn't being sexist. Maybe he wasn't trying to order women around. Maybe he was just trying to help us.
Just stand back.
This woman with the baby, good distance. Plenty of room, no pressure. has another stupid human between her and a horse. So just in case the horse attacks the closest stupid human because they threatened her baby, this is a buffer for this lady with her child. And she puts herself between the child and the horse. So she has two buffers between the horse. Now, this isn't saying the horses are mean or unpredictable. This is just like, look, the baby just called stressed. Mom just came in. I don't know. Again, I'm only going by what I see. Somebody will come here with all this new information. Well, you don't know what you're... because they own the horse and they own the baby and they were imprinting it. I don't care about all that, you big dummies. I'm telling you from what I'm seeing here, these women got good far out of the way. This one's a little closer than I would have probably liked to have been, because if the horse came in and felt any danger at all or she moved, the mom could have just kicked out to say, hey, you're getting a little close. My baby just called me. I don't know who the hell you are, and I want you to move. So she's a little closer than I would feel comfortable being, me personally. This one, I think, is smart. Plenty of room. No mistake. I've got a lot of room for this horse to get to her mom. I don't want to be in a way. I don't want to be close. I don't want to be looked at. I don't want to be perceived as a threat. So I like her position better than this position.
She's fine. She's fine.
I don't like the fact that mom has a stupid halter on because some idiot out there can't catch a freaking horse, so we got to leave a halter on it. Matter of fact, let me show a quick picture on a horse since I spoke about that. Hang on. So I'm going to add this to my website. Somebody sent me this picture. They found this, I think, in Nebraska, a horse skull that a horse died out somewhere in a pasture, obviously. And the skull was the only thing left. And you can see where somebody put probably a halter on a baby because they were too stupid to catch their horse. Or they bought into this stupid, I got to imprint it. I got to get a halter on it while it's a baby. Otherwise, I'm too stupid to do it when it gets older. So they put this halter on his horse. And the horse died a horrible death. Probably cut its oxygen and airflow off. He couldn't breathe through his nose. Probably choked him over here. Horrible death. Bone grew around it. Horse tried to make it. Couldn't eat. Couldn't open his mouth. Starved. Just a horrible death because of halters. And there's going to be idiots out there that are going to come here and make stupid videos about, he don't like women. He don't like halters. There's nothing wrong with keeping a halter on a horse. Oh, the ignorance in the horse world. And back to mommy and baby.
He's fine.
Checks on horse. Gives a little tail swishing here. You notice how mom walks in with purpose, with direction, with mom's not like walking around wondering like I'm lost. What should I do next? Where should I? Mom took a straight beeline to her baby, walked through three people, because there's a guy filming on this side, and there's two women, or three, two and a child on the other side, walked right down the middle and said, I'm going to my baby, and anybody gets in my way got to deal with me. So her tail is active. Her body position is very dominating or very assured of herself. And somewhat, I don't want to say intimidating, but she wants to come in with, don't mess with me, I'm on a mission. And, you know, again, if these people would have been closer, she might have went, you're too close. She might have either grabbed one of them and bit them if they would have been blocking the doorway. She could have kicked out. She could have knocked them over. She could have headbutted them or rammed them with her nose or mouth. So she could have done all this, but because they moved, because they caught the clue, because they got out of the way and they didn't want to stand there and argue and be know-it-alls, there was no issues. Had somebody got kicked, bit, or hurt, it would have been the stupid human's fault and not the horse. And that's why I always say it's never the horse's fault. And I know the idiots are going to be out there, well, Rick, the horse is mean and it shouldn't kick people and it shouldn't bite. And, you know, horses need to be respectful and you got to show them who's boss. Well, then you're an idiot. And you're the one that's going to be going to the hospital from getting kicked and stepped on, where I did that helmet video where all the idiots had helmets on and they got bit and kicked and stepped on and they were in ER. So you'll just be one of those stats out there running your mouth. I thought this was a good little video. Again, I might have done it before. I don't know if I did, if I covered the same topics. But when I watched it, I thought it'd be a good little lesson.
All right. So,
hopefully you got something out of it. She takes her baby. Baby immediately bonds up.
He's like, Mom, they were touching me.
Notice her tail. Notice she gets them away from the stupid humans. She gets them away from her baby who was feeling insecure. And the baby bonded and went right next to her. When you see these idiots who are imprinting these babies and got to be around them and hug them and you got to rub them, Rick, and you got to show them and you got to do it when they're young so when they get older you won't be able to do it because you're an idiot. This is what you want a relationship with a mom and a baby. A horse is the best teacher of a horse. This mom has forgotten more about a horse than any stupid human knows. And she knows how to raise her baby and knows how to teach that horse. And she's going to make it easier to work with that horse when that horse gets older. Because if you understand a horse, you're going to understand that baby. But what happens is you get stupid humans out there trying to imprint them and teach them all this human crap. They screw them up. The baby's confused. The mom rejects it. The baby doesn't know whether to go to the mom or the human. And it learns all these bad lessons. And then they can't be trained. And they're put down and they're given to slaughter. And they're labeled oxygen deprived, mean, unhandleable. The horse is crazy. The mom was no good. And you get all these stupid excuses out there. When in fact, if the humans just stay out of it, the mom will teach the baby how to be a horse. And then if you understand a horse, you'll be able to work with the horse when it's older and not have to be so damn scared to work with it when it's older that you have to maul it when it's a damn baby. All right? Hopefully you got something out of that. We'll end that there. Buddy, Mr. T, your good boys.